What's going on, guys, and welcome back to another video. So today we're going to give updates on two penny stocks that I've made a lot of videos on in the past. I'll link them in the description below in the form of High Tide, ticker symbol HITIF, and Health Your Choice Management, ticker symbol HCMC. So what we'll do, we'll look at their current share price and see how they're performing over the last few weeks. And most importantly, we look at some of their catalysts to see if there's any updates on those which will definitely impact their price going forward, and even if there's any new catalyst for any of these stocks. And with all that being said, let's dive right on over to Trading 212. Firstly, let's have a very brief look at the current share price for these two stocks and see if I hold either of these positions within my Trading 212 portfolio. So with High Tide, I currently have 261 shares. That equates about 130 euro invested or so it's not a whole lot of capital. Again, with penny stocks, because they're so volatile, I do not want to have a lot of my overall portfolio invested in these. We can see here for the likes of High Tide, on the 1 week chart, down about 11%. Again, which we'll see later on, I find very bizarre, considering everything is going well for them. So that you need to take all penny stocks with a pinch of salt, in terms of pump and dump schemes. So a lot of the bigger investors will certainly be buying in these stocks, then selling as quick as they can, effectively dropping the price drastically, and then they'll buy in at the cheap prices again. So again, if you think that's right or wrong, like in terms of morale, I don't know myself, but it does happen. So for example, we can see here that even over the last week, it's down 11%, and the points we're going to mention now, they're all going in their favor at the moment. So for me, this is a great opportunity to dollar cost average. You can even see here at the moment, we're down 7% in my holding. So again, that's just buying at a discount to my opinion. And because penny stocks are so volatile, I only buy small quantities at any given time. For example, over the last week or so, I bought about 25 euros worth on two occasions, so I continue to do that at current prices. And again, I can't stress enough, if you're a long-term investor, you need to look at the long-term charts, not just the one-day or one-week charts. So if you look at the three-month chart, for example, on High Tide, it looks a lot better, even though, for example, it's still, my average price is about 62 cent or so at the moment, or 61.5 cent, where its current price is about 59 cent. So hopefully, because it's down about 7% at the moment, I'm going to buy more, effectively dropping my overall dotted line average cost, and over the long term, making a bigger profit. Again, the reason why I find it so bizarre that their stock is down about 11% over the last week is because everything is still going in their favor. So that just goes to show that I already said about the pump and dump style schemes. But as a long-term investor, this gives the smarter guys like you and I a great opportunity to buy in at cheaper prices. For example, all the points I like to list, for any stock I hold, I always write down the catalysts. And for High Tide, it's no different. We can see here all the points that I mentioned in prior videos, such as product offering, diversification, celebrity endorsements, great CEO, it's ever expanding, the leading Canadian cannabis stock. We're still waiting for an update on the filing for the NASDAQ. Now that can be a huge catalyst. So it's currently in the process. And again, as you can imagine, if they get onto the NASDAQ, this is going to be great exposure and will only be a benefit to their share price. Mergers and acquisitions are still going ahead. We're going to mention that later on as well. Also, they had great quarter one earnings. Now, as you can imagine, once the quarter earnings results come out, it will have a bit of a pump. And then originally, once the overall hype dies down, it will start to die down the overall share price as well. That happens, but that's just psychology, so that happens all the time. But today, I want to focus on the kind of bottom two here in terms of reducing interest rates and opening even more stores. A lot of the points mentioned at WarDoc, there isn't a lot of updates on them at the moment. However, they are all very important catalysts. So in my opinion, they're not doing anything wrong at all, this company. They're doing quite well and ticking all the boxes. For example, as a penny stock, you can imagine a lot of penny stocks have a lot of debt. But we can see here now that they're after extending the maturity date, effectively reducing their interest rates on a debt down below, which is up to $2 million in debentures. So this debenture reduction in interest rates will effectively cut the interest rate from 10% down to 7%. Again, that 3% is huge for smaller companies. So again, just like all the other points I mentioned in the WarDoc, they really are ticking all the boxes in my opinion. Now, it kind of goes without saying that I'm not a financial advisor, so you need to do your own due diligence before investing any of your hard-earned money. But again, usually I am quite skeptical with a lot of penny stocks. And again, I'm not affiliated to this stock either, if that's what you think, but I'm usually quite skeptical with a lot of penny stocks, as I said, but this High Tide really is one of the penny stocks, especially really one of the few that I actually believe have a lot of potential in the long term. Again, one of the main things you want to see with penny stocks is expansion and diversification, and High Tide again is ticking this box. You can see they're after opening their 81st store in Canada, in Toronto. So this is brilliant news because it really does improve their overall exposure, and it really does put them in a great foundation base within this market. In summary for High Tide, I'll certainly be buying more of the shares. I currently have about 260, as I stated earlier. So I do definitely want to get that to at least 300, 250 by the end of this week. We have 100 euro in free funds to invest this week that I plan to invest. So again, because the current share price is about 59 or 60 cent a share, you can imagine you can get quite a lot of shares for not a lot of capital. So I will be hoping to take advantage of this dip over the last few days. And the second penny stock is Healthier Choice Management, ticker symbol HCMC. Now, unlike High Tide, I don't really have, first of all, I have no holdings. I want to be fully transparent. I don't have any holdings within this stock. And there's probably a lot of reasons why. For example, over the last month alone, it's down 38%, and it's currently trading at 0.0011 cent of a share. So you can imagine that I didn't even think you could buy shares that cheap, to be honest. So again, this could pose a lot of opportunity as well if you have faith in the lawsuit that we'll discuss in a bit. But for me, this isn't a stock that I'm currently invested in, nor do I think I'll be invested in the future. And the reason I'm not invested in HMC in comparison to High Tide is simply because of fundamentals. For example, with High Tide, we can see a list here of at least 10 different fundamental factors that will act as catalysts going forward for this company. Again, that doesn't mean they'll all come true, but it has a high chance of a lot of these being major catalysts going forward. So if I had to compare this to, let's say, the likes of HMC, the only thing I can think of off the top of my head is the lawsuit. And if I'm being honest, about at least 80 to 90% of investors within HMC are solely invested in the stock, mainly because of the lawsuit. And I believe even if they win the lawsuit, the people that have invested will get out as quick as they can once they make a profit, effectively will drop the share price regardless. And even if they don't win, as you can imagine, this will be disastrous for the stock as well. But again, we'll discuss that later on. But kind of the main reason why I'm not invested is due to fundamentals. Now, don't get me wrong, HMC certainly isn't a complete dead rubber, in my opinion. They have tried to make some strides over the last few months as well. First of these, it might be strange enough, but they're after actually making an official Twitter page. Now, that might seem absolutely crazy for some people in terms of having that as news. However, it is very important because as a penny stock, there is a lot of kind of fake news as such. So this is great for investors because we'll clarify a lot of things within the stock. Second of all, they've also relaunched their online store. Now, as I mentioned, most people in this stock are not looking for the fundamentals. They're solely based on the lawsuit. So I bet you most people don't have any kind of interest that they have launched a store again, even if they are invested within this company, because again, they're all about the lawsuit. With all penny stocks, there is a lot of market manipulation. We even saw with High Tide there, even though it's a great company, again, that's just my opinion. In terms of fundamentals, it has been a quite a rocky road over the last few weeks, and that's mainly due to the bigger investors scalping profits and taking profits from small gains and kind of pump and dump schemes. So again, that will definitely happen with HMC as well, and people are making a lot of money from scalping these types of stocks as well. But long term, I don't feel that HMC has a lot of potential. You can imagine the main catalyst, and certainly is probably 90% of the catalyst, is got to do with the lawsuit with HMC. Now, if you're unaware of this lawsuit, it's got to do with patent infringements for a vape that Philip Morris use. So HMC are making these allegations against Philip Morris. There was no surprise that once they made these allegations, Philip Morris counteracted the claims, and we're currently waiting for a response from HMC again. So we are really waiting to see the outcome of this lawsuit. Now, originally, if HMC hadn't got a good law team behind them, I would have said they had no chance, mainly due to the overall capital difference between the two companies. However, HMC have got a fairly well-established and reputable kind of law team put together for this lawsuit. Again, I mentioned in prior videos, there's three outcomes here. The two obvious ones that either win or lose this lawsuit. And the third that a lot of people don't actually think about is that Philip Morris might actually buy out HMC, which again would actually be good for the share price. But again, we'll have to see how this goes. It's really up in the air at the moment. And anytime there is an update on this lawsuit, I'll be sure to let you know. But that's pretty much it for me today. I just wanted to give a very brief update on HTMC, Healthier Choice Management, and also High Tide, ticker symbol HITIF, and if there was any updates on any of the catalysts that will act as a huge driver for the share price going forward. If you found this video anywhere helpful or entertaining, it'd be much appreciated as always if you're new around here, if you consider subscribing to the channel. And if you could smash that like button, it would really help me and the channel out going forward. Finally, I'd be very interested to know in the comment section below if you hold either of these two stocks and your reasoning behind them. Thanks very much, enjoy your Monday, and I will see you all in tomorrow's video.